Okay, today we are looking at the pre-operative management. We are going to look at elective and emergency management. So under these two managements, I came up with an acronym of which I say REPIP NOPSIP. So this acronym covers the elective part of managing this patient before going for theater, and also the emergency part of managing this patient before going for theater. In this context, I'm going to focus mainly on elective management. So under the elective part, the first word according to my acronym REPIP NOPSIP is AIMS. So under AIMS, here you write or talk about what you want to achieve before the date of the operation. One of the general aim to achieve before the date of an operation is to make sure you allay the anxiety of the patient. And the other thing is you want to prevent post-operative complications. Under the environment, you need to know the environment where you are going to admit the patient as they are awaiting for the due date of an operation. One of the things that you need to put in consideration is to make sure that this environment is clean in order to prevent infections. And how are you going to achieve that? You are going to achieve that by making sure that you dam dust the area, or rather the environment where the patient is. So the other part is resuscitation, but resuscitation we are not going to focus it under elective management, but this one it will be more focused under the emergency pre-op management. In this context, I'm going to jump to investigations. So under the investigation here, you look at, you're going to take a blood. So this blood, you're going to consider the hemoglobin level for this patient. And on females there, you discover that the HB level should be between the range of 10 to 12. And for males, it should be in the range of 14 to 16. The other thing that you're going to consider under the investigations is full blood count, which is very important. The other thing, you are going to get also x-rays and other investigations that you see that are necessary for this patient. The other part is psychological care. So psychological, it deals with the mind. So here you need to explain to the patient the importance of doing this procedure on the patient. So under psychological care, you need to emphasize and stress a point, the importance and the deep details on why this procedure should be done on the patient. The other part is identity. So on identity, you need to write the name, the age and sex, the word and the type of operation that should be done to this patient. The other part is prophylactic drugs. So these are just the drug, the antibiotics that you are going to give to this patient as they are waiting for the due date of an operation. So these antibiotics should be given to this patient. The other part is the nutrition. So the nutrition, this patient should be deprived of anything between the range of 6 to 8 hours. In this context, we are trying to prevent aspiration of this patient as they are operating in the theater. The other part is observation. Observation, so these are the vitals that you are going to do to this patient. We want to make sure that the vitals are in a normal range. So you are going to be taking the temperature to make sure that it is in the normal range. If the temperature is high, then we suspect infection. The pulse, the respiration, and the blood pressure. The other thing that we need to consider is physical preparation. So under physical preparation, we look at the aspect of cannulation. We need to cannulate this patient. We need to catheterize this patient. We need to bath this patient and trim the incision site. The other part is the consent form. So the consent form just gives us the approval that saying that the patient has accepted the operation to be done on him or her. The other part is immediate care. So this is just the care that you do few hours before taking the patient for an operation. So you make sure that all the investigations are up to date and they are within the patient. Pre-medication. These are the medication that you give prior to taking the patient for an operation. So these medication, they reduce the anxiety of the patient and also reduce secretions.